You know, I think the first and the most important thing is support from the business. You know, both Stephen and I have come from actually doing the job and firefighting. And, you know, I was a CISO, a Chief Information Security Officer, and I'd often laugh and I'd say, well, CISO actually stands for career is so over. Because the reality is, if there is a breach, you're the one that ultimately is held accountable and ultimately blamed, even though you may not have had support from the business. So first and foremost, the most important thing is to have, is as a CEO, to back and support this. Because the reality is your employees aren't going to take things seriously if they don't believe the CEO believes in security and information governance. And
does that require a breach to focus people's minds typically, or is it enough to just be educated?
No, there was a great example where I was working for a water company and we actually had a letter of support from the CEO to all employees just outlining his commitment to information security and information risk. Right. And that was enough such that we as the security team could go and speak to people to say, well, actually, this is why we need to do this. So having the support from the business is the most important element. You know, back to Stephen's point, knowing your risk is the first thing. And actually then knowing where you want to be. After that, it should be straightforward. If you know where you are and where you want to be and you have the support from the business, then, you know, those are the foundations, in my opinion.
What I found fascinating about organisations that need a breach is often one is not enough. Because when one happens, if they're in the mindset they need a breach to do something, one, it's a one-off, it'll never happen again. It's the second or third that gets them then tending to massively overreact. But I find most organisations, with all the media attention, with all the regulatory attention on this topic, even if they haven't had something themselves, they're wise enough to see around them, see what's happening, and start thinking about this issue to make sure they're in the right place.
And obviously, to your point earlier, you almost risk, in some cases, getting to the point where breaches aren't seen to be that big a deal. You said earlier, well, credit cards are credit cards. You know, one can deal with a credit card.
And I think that's the thing about the change in the CISO role, is now how well you handle the breach is much more important than if you have one. Everyone's going to have one. If you handle it well, if that team are on top of it, are well-connected, have support at the right levels, then they're doing their job correctly.
So it's a question of aligning the organisation, spending the budgets in the right way, and presumably also the planning around how you actually deal with it when it happens,
yes,
and making sure that both from a reputational perspective but also from a follow-up perspective.
And tangibly, if you're on one of these boards and you haven't gone through an exercise of planning what you do, the time to do that is not 2 a.m. on a Sunday morning when a journalist is phoning you up and asking what you're doing about it. It's to practice that over and over again. So there's a very tangible thing senior people in organizations can do, is take part in a tabletop exercise. What would we do if one of these big name breaches happened to us?